Alright, so first I want to start by saying Kalalal Yahweh Bashem Yahushai Bashem Raka Kodash, which is to give all praises to the Heavenly Father in the name of His Son and in the name of the Holy Spirit. I also want to say double honors to the apostles and elders of James Rope Mistone and to Akim out there pushing the truth in sincerity, the hopeful elect, Shalom. Alright, so this is Brother Canaan from James Jamaica. I'm going to try to make this lesson quick. And this is going to be about those celebrities, so-called Jamaican celebrities that are now jumping out the closet to now just expose themselves for who they are, which is really homo. And the word homo just means basically same. You know what I mean? So basically these are homosexuals, people that are doing the same sex, same gender. You know what I mean? And for it's the female seems to be on our role, because I guess females are less bashed in Jamaica or in society overall when it comes to being homos, you know? And it's so funny that this so-called society that we describe as a homophobic society, and the culture that is supposed to be homophobic, which is reggae music and dancehall, contains so much homos. It's crazy. It is literally crazy, but not to a shocking stand for us as men of the Lord, because we know that these people are not what they say they are. You know, they don't have any morals, and they're losing, or they did, they're losing, they've lost all those morals, yo, because of the greed of money and basically just getting indulged or mixing among certain society, you know, and gravitating onto who is leading the world today, which is the so-called white man. His ways and his agenda has encompassed many of our people, and our people are now living like vile individuals. You know what I mean? Being vile, being immoral, being, you know, senseless to natural way of life. And they find all type of excuse to say, this is the reason why. Oh, men have hurt us. So because men have hurt you, you should be, the stupid type of explanation that they find. You know what I mean? Right? So this is what the topic this is going to be about. These people that are jumping out, that are being revealed for who they truly are. You know what I mean? The scripture says they declare their sin as Sodom. I'm going to read it real quick. This is Isaiah 3 and verse 9. The shoe of their countenance doth witness against them, and they declare their sin as Sodom. We all know what Sodom is famous for. Nastiness, immorality, men to men, men with dogs, men with cows, men with all type of animal, bestiality. You name it. Females doing all type of nastiness. You know what I mean? Yo, it's just crazy. And Sodom is here today. Little Sodom. America is a little Sodom. Or if you want to call it a big Sodom, whichever you want to do. America is Sodom. You know what I mean? The society is based on this so-called democratic way of life, where you are free to do anything that is wrong. Being pedophiles, being homosexual, being, you know, whatever you want to name it. You know what I mean? And for them terms of how them put certain things, it's just how they put it. You know what I mean? But we know, you know? Yeah, so I'm just trying to show you that society today is just disgusting overall. And these men that are leading the world, these leaders, so-called white men, they are in charge of this type of thing. They are, you know, the reason why society is going the way it's going. Because if there were real rulers saying, oh, if you're doing this, then this is the judgment. Guess what? The first three persons will do it and they get punished. People that take heed. But no, they are not taking heed. They are jumping out the closet. Jumping out because, you know, it's a free for all. They say, oh, the person jump out and the society bought them. No, I'm going to show you the hypocrisy of this jumping the closet thing, right, taking place. No. Some of these female artists in Jamaica that are coming out, you know. You have the Lila Ike. She basically was going to get exposed, and based on what we are seeing, that's the reason why she came to the forefront. So she didn't, based on what we are seeing and our allegation and what we are seeing, our allegations out there, basically she was going to be exposed, so she exposed herself. So she was going to be a hypocrite all along and be who she was until that time frame came. So she jumped aboard and do it. And I guess her co-workers, our partners, our friends would have known her activities, but they would have stuck with her one thing. And the reason I'm going to speak on Lila Ike for, because she started it all started raveling from her. Well, we know that persons before would have basically exposed themselves or said certain things, and I'm the Shenzia, the Spice. Well, Spice never come out so bold, but we all saw it. Spice dancers are lesbians. Spice would have given hint about certain things. Again, show me a company, I'm tell you who we are. Birds of a feather flock together. Can two walk together unless they agree? You know what I mean? Nothing's changed. You're seeing people partner with gays. It means that them gay. Or them have some form of gay affiliation. Because if you're against something, you cannot be with it. No, people work in an environment where people like this exist. You know what I mean? But if you go into that environment, you realize that them people there stay away from certain people. You know what I mean? Unless you don't know so certain persons are like that, then it's out of your reach because you wouldn't know. Because again, persons are living under the, you know. But when a person jump out and you support it, then you are showing that you are for that lifestyle and you're disgusting, just as the person would have done that. You know what I mean? So let's go back to the Lila Ike thing. Now, there's another artist around this person, which is called Coffee. And there's been speculation out there showing that Coffee is on the other side. Coffee is a homo. You know what I mean? Coffee behave and act as if she's a dude. You know what I mean? And persons that would have known her or claimed that they know her, went to school with her, would have told her that she was always like that, into girls. You know what I mean? Okay. Now, person may say, oh, Coffee's around protege and chronics, and these men are men of high morals and rastas, and these men are against this type of thing. But how would she be around these people and they know that she's that? Something not right. Well, something is not right because the men that are around her support the nastiness, and that's why they accept her, because they would have must known these things all along. And the fact that they're now supporting Lila Ike shows that they already knew about Coffee long ago. And this is showing you that these people are nasty men. These people are, they have no moral. We've been telling you the Rasta community is a nasty community that has, they have no moral, they have no way of life. They just take on different path and they go as long. Now for them, just a sellout, period. You know what I mean? Nastiness. Alright? So, that point out that there, when it comes to those two females, you know what I mean, that are associated with the, now, the Jada Kingdom, them jump out, the Spice, the Shenzia, you name it. You know, before, again, just look up before, men, most of dancehall females are whores, gays, are homos, whichever they really want for you to call them, whichever term them call themselves, LGBT, they name themselves. Anywhere they call themselves, we are calling it. You see me? That's who they are, you know? These people are so, this is a nasty setup, yo. Overall, it is just a nasty, disgusting setup. I want to see someone jump into that field. They are a nasty person. Because it's a nasty industry. It's a living, nasty industry, yo. I want to see them involved. Why would you want to date a female that is a part of a society like that or industry like that? They are nasty. You know what I mean? And people do with girl and music know these things, yo. Some of them might hide and pretend like, say, yo, oh, them are cut above the rest. No. You can't trick with. We know the thing. You know what I mean? We have friends that are in the industry when it comes on to music, males. You know what I mean? So we know the thing go. You know what I mean? So don't give you that type of thing. Like people is naive, and Jamaica is very small, so people know people. You know what I mean? Anyways, yeah, so these people are now jumping out. Now look at this. These people are now looked on and by Jamaicans or people overseas as celebrities and more people to establish moral compass to your children. Them also they don't believe in that, but people are a little leaven the whole lump. A little nastiness that is passed on from a song that is being repeated over and over, and a style that is being done, you know what I mean? It takes time and it eats away the person's moral spine, and they become spineless and they become nasty, yo. Why do you think society today is full of so much bi lesbians or gays or homos or whichever word you know one call themselves? Why you think that? You think it just magically happened? No, we know that there's no new thing under the sun. However, you know what I mean, at one point our society was not so much into this type of folly. It is clear as day that there's an increased amount of homos going around, and this is because a little leaven the whole lump, which I'm going to read that scripture. You know what I mean? This is 1 Corinthians 5 and verse 6. It says, says, your glorying is not good. Your glorying is not good. These people like to glorify themselves. Oh, them people are star and all them private jet. You're living nasty life, yo. You're living nasty life. And for the ones that are going into number two, how can you be somebody to glorify yourself and you're playing with mess? Like, yo. Anyways, so it says here, your glorying is not good. Know ye not that a little leaven at the whole lump? Know you not that a little leaven the whole lump? It says, purge out therefore the old leaven that you may be a new lump. As you are unleavened, for even Yahushua, our Passover is sacrificed for us. So you have to get rid of the things that are creating these lumps, and are basically not the lump, creating the whole lump to be leaven. You know what I mean? So again, society would have structured their music, the television industry, the Hollywood, the movies, the cartoons, all that, and they're indulging or encouraging people into certain lifestyle, and they're pushing it on you. Oh, it's not that about us accepting, you know. They are telling you to accept them and to basically to feel comfortable to be, keep us, you know, by right. It's supposed to get purged, but because we don't have power right now, keep yourself to yourself, yo. Stop trying to, you know. Because you're gonna invade someone's space, just like how you think you have a space, and someone's gonna brush you, and eventually it's gonna lead to that part. You know what I mean? But these females out here we're talking about, these males also that they are talking about, that they know the who are a part of the bundle, you know, the part of the stick. They know the members that, because they know themselves. You know what I mean? But again, many are not going to come out and say. But everything will be revealed in due time. All right. So these says these the little leaven. So you're now having these leaven out there, causing your younger generation to become whores, and boys and gays and whatever you name again name them, and you're wondering what is taking place. You grow your daughter and you realize your daughter enjoys being a whore, and she now wants to be a homo, you know what I mean? And you're wondering what take place. You never tell her for this yet. She never see you bringing as a mom. She never see you bringing a woman yet. But yet still she's doing it. Where did she see it? Where did she learn it from? The same celebrities that are out there doing this type of thing, the movies, they must see it out there. It has come from there. Has to be a source where it's coming from, you know? And if the source was purged, then it wouldn't stop. But society allows and protects the source and give them rights more than oh, me and you have rights, because we are nobody, but they are everything. You know what I mean? And we have to so-called live with it. So where things are spread, the virus has spread, just like how the COVID situation has spread. And I mean, they're not trying to put a lid on this. They want to spread this virus. I'm not talking about the COVID. I'm talking about the Omo virus. They want to spread it. They want you to indulge in it and feel free to be it. It's okay for you to be it according to them. That's how messed up these leaders are, yo. You know? And you realize that the population are drawn to it, and you wonder what it's a phenomenon, you wonder what takes place. You've been programmed. You've been seduced into folly. You know what I mean? And then the males that are, you know better, because if you support, if you're a male, just like Phantom Mojo, your so-called Rasta stand by moral. You used to burn, walk with a spray paint on your back and burn the most fire. Or burn the most fire. You still you have 10, 15 girls in your bed for sure, say you're a galley, say you're, or you're whatever king you call yourself. Which is stupid, you know what I mean? Because if you bring two females in a bed, and you have sexual content or whatever with them, you're encouraging them to that it's okay for both females to be in bed together doing certain things, and it doesn't matter if you are there or not. So eventually, when them bed by themselves, that whatever is there is no is still there by themselves. This type of nonsense. And then you see the videos them coming out with these dancer artists now. They are putting two females on the in videos to kiss each other and all of these things, and it's being accepted more and more. But then it would have been an outrage, yo. So these people are vile, are vain, nasty, disgusting, and they are destroying society, yo, declaring themselves as their sin, as Sodom, being proud of what they're doing. But guess what happened to Sodom? Sodom was destroyed, Sodom was burnt. And the same thing is going to happen to this Sodom. It's going to be burnt, and all Sodomites, all other mites, you know what I mean? You are going to be burnt up with Sodom. You know what I mean? Because of the work that you are doing make the place what it is. You know what I mean? So it rightfully needs to burn with you guys. Anyways, let me get to the next scripture, right? So this is Leviticus 19 and verse 29. It says, "Do not prostitute thy daughter to cause her to be a whore, lest the land fall toward them and the land become full of wickedness." And you're clearly seeing that the land is already fall into wickedness and become wickedness, you know what I mean? And they are worse. Some of these females, we know females that, you know, some of them poor, and them, and not all this come from poor background, but we know females that are poor, and you know, some of them do certain things to survive. Not saying that this is right nonetheless, because you're still a whore, you know what I mean? However, you have females that would have gone way over these so-called wars that we have as wars today. You know what I mean? A girl jump around 5, 7, 10 man, and you know that's bad. But these females that are celebrities, some of them are gone way over the numbers where them look. Some of them girls are gone over the 20, 30. Them been through so many man, it's disgusting, yo. And again, if you've been with more than one man in your lifetime and in the lifetime of these men, then you are a whore, because you would have not been released from your husband, the man that take your virginity, or the person you sleep with first. You're a pastor, you're being a vile person. And that's the whole purpose of what we are saying about being a whore. If you're in that shoe, then you're a whore. It is just the truth. No, does it mean that you must die because you're a whore? You can repent from these things. However, if you don't repent and acknowledge that you are and you want to change, then you're going to die. You know what I mean? That's just the truth. So he said, you know, to prostitute daughter to cause her to become a whore, lest the land become fall toward them and the place full of wickedness. And we are seeing that there are beer whores out there. And prostituting, look how society is messed up in the head. Females today just tend to, you know, have no shame. Like I said, I was explaining this earlier. So this female, it's not just one female. Alright, you're in an environment, a professional environment, where a person is supposed to dress professional and carry themselves in a certain way. And you're in an environment where persons are wearing outfits that their breasts can drop out of them clothes and they not even realize, and them dip on the floor. On a professional environment with them breasts outside, wearing no bra, them top is already, You can just imagine that the top cannot even cover the girl's breast to all the outfit that she in, and she the breast man for said to her, say cover up herself. She didn't even realize it, yo, and it's more than one time. Your female coming out environment with no bra, see through top. What the heck? And you're coming in professional institution to come and work. You should not wear that none at all unless you're going to your bedroom with your purse, with your partner, a male, you know what I mean? However, you're freely walking up and down on the road like that, and then you wonder why somehow you guys get raped. Oh, are you wear what you want to wear or whatever. Not saying that it is okay for people to just see people and grab people, but protect yourself. Act sensible. You know what I mean? Act sensible, but people are today just naive and stupid. You know? Person's going to the beach, like this dude tell his female, you're not come out of the house today with that, you know, put on something more. So she was in a bath suit, basically, was going into the vehicle. So some people was going to pick them up, and he didn't want her to go into the vehicle like that. You're going in the same beach with the same people, them, and she's going to take off a said shot in front of the same people, them. Like, what is wrong with society? Or people are just destroyed for lack of knowledge. You're dumb and stupid. And if you're still, but a beach and they will spoil. So because you're on the beach environment gives you the right for you to expose yourself to everyone that is on the beach. Because it is the beach. It is just bull crap, yo. And it's just show you, because people just think, okay, this gives you the right. Oh, it is a party that is a pajama party, so you can dress this way. So they create environment and give it, oh, because it is this, it is now suitable for you to dress this way in this environment. No, it's not suitable. You know what I mean? And this is just, really and truly, these people are not going to learn. You know what I mean? Especially when it comes to female. Females are emotional and drawn to what they are, you know, or they have their reason why they're doing everything, and you know, they're gonna get the support because, oh, a female, what is, you know, just what little against me, because a lot of males out there that are, you are nasty, just the same, you're worse too, you know, being in the closet. Some of you guys would have come out the closet also, you know what I mean, but yo, it's just disgusting, yo, overall, man to man, woman to woman. Man to the beast, all these nasty folly crap that is taking place, you are going to be put to death. You know what I mean? The Most High is going to put a work on you, people, for the folly that you've been endorsing and pushing and promoting and yourself taking part in. You know what I mean? So, there's no surprise why you're seeing females today just being reckless and nasty and all of that. And people being reckless and nasty, it's just no surprise. It has been, the leaven has been spreading, and it's surely taking its toll, you know? All right, so I'm going to read the last precept and just wrap up, because again, didn't want to make it too long, but, you know, you're kind of leading into this ranting thing, you know what I mean? All right, so let me just, this is Ecclesiasticus 26, sorry. Let's start from 25. Let's gonna jump around a few precepts here. It says, and this is 26:22. An harlot is an harlot shall be accounted as spittle, but a married woman is a terror unto against death to her husband. So an harlot, a whore, is deemed as spit. You're accounted as spit. You're nothing according to the Bible. You're looked at as spit. And we have a lot of spits on this earth today. Whether they're my family or not, it doesn't change the fact that, yo, we are, the Bible says we're a filthy rag, our righteousness are a filthy rag. You know what I mean? And for you, your spits. Let's continue. 25. A shameless woman shall be counted as a dog. And a girl that was walk on the road naked, she don't have no shame. Say if you're half or semi-naked or whatever you want to call it, you still have no shame. Once you're not covered properly, you don't have any shame. Once someone is seeing you naked in a certain way and you don't feel a way about it, you don't have any shame. Once you're doing certain things in certain ways and you don't feel a way about it, you don't have any shame. Just look at dancehall culture, look at the hip-hop culture, look at all this culture. These females don't wear clothes. The persons that are in dancehall, dancing for a so-called living, They like to tell you that, oh, they're also making the money. You are whores out there nonetheless. They say, oh, see, don't touch or whatever, whatever. But so you wonder, who the hell wives these females? Do they have males? Do they have, and they realize why they are lesbians, yo. Because which men are going to accept a female and behave that way, they, yo. And no say, yo, oh, she's out there being like that to the public. And this is mine. This is not mine. This is the public. You know what I mean? So females tend to accept that because they are vile in themselves. They're gonna turn to females, yo. That's why many dancers turn to females because the man not gonna take them or take them or look for them serious either. Because again, you are out there being, and the time man come to him and look for a knock and move. So they say, oh man, don't treat them good. You've put yourself out there to be treated like that also. You exhaust yourself as being a whore, and they would have taken you as a whore. I'm not saying that it is right, but that's what would have happened. This is why you don't want to, why you don't want a female become an artist or a female become a dancer. Like, what? Do you not see the videos of these people are being treated? Do you not see how they're dressed? They are literally, they are whores. All right, let me not sing on that too much. You know what I mean? So, now be a dead arse, you know? Let's go on more ranting and all that. But you can see it, the Leela'i, the Jada Kingdom, the Diana King from back then, the Spice, the Coffee, the Shenseea, dancehall, so-called dancehall female acts, the hip-hop acts, the Cardi B, the what's that? Nicki Minaj, fear her name alone supposed to tell you everything. The other females out there, you see that these females are prostitutes, they are whores, they're selling themselves, and they normally come on being sexual, yo. You know? So with that, I was gonna wrap it up, you know. Do females jumping out the closet? You may jumping out the closet also, or you know, taking your time coming out. The Most I already see you, there's no closet to the Heavenly Father. You've been marked, you know what I mean? And it's just a matter of time before the Most I put you out to death. So that I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushai. That was again to the apostles, and it was a James Stone, and take him out there. Shalom.